Hello and welcome back to another video for Final Fantasy XIV with me, Mione. This time I'm on my Dragoon today because I need to get some EXP, and there's lots of side quests that have unlocked after I have completed the MSQ. So full spoilers herein, as you've seen from the title and of course the actual thumbnail as well. I mean, it's non-descriptive, it's just a box. So what is in the box is everyone's question, and you've probably Googled this, the secret in the box quest. Now, if you're unfamiliar with this quest, essentially the prerequisites for this to appear, it's right here. If we look at the map, let's make this nice and big for you. It's over here at X10.6.11.0, just off from the main etherite. This quest will show up, and it's got full level sync, so you might as well level something with the experience. You need to have first completed the outside help quest, which is part of the main scenario storyline at level 88, and also have a Disciple of War and Magic at level 80 to pick it up, obviously. Now, we're not going to worry too much about the actual dialogue, but this is one of those quests where you basically have to solve a riddle. So you can read this in your own time if you would wish to. I've already read through this a couple of times. Basically what happens is this lady is instructed with giving you a box, and inside the box is something. They don't say what. And then there's an unsigned letter that says, "Dear Mione, there is a gift for you in the box if you can open it. To do so, you must acquire 3 keys, the keepers of which are somewhere in Charlion. Solve the following riddles to find them, and do try to have fun. This is a game, after all. Towards wisdom aspiring, a keeper doth gaze, by young minds inquiring, and new trails blazed. Yet the mind is a muscle, in rest it doth grow, so let all embrace slumber, the better to know." So that's the first bit. You can probably figure this out on your own. Clues include definitely in rest doth it grow, mind is a muscle, so what happens when your mind is tired? You go to sleep. So that means you're looking potentially for somebody who's asleep. It says a keeper doth gaze. Now Thaliak is the keeper of Charlion, so you know the direction we're kind of going, right? And it says embrace slumber. So maybe you will be embracing slumber. Next it says, "By life ever flowing, a keeper doth wait, clutching a prize, his hunger to sate. Yet no prize is so coveted as one golden hued, the mention of which is never thought rude." This last one will come to them. Sorry for the second one. And then the third clue is, "Blessed by the nymphi, a keeper doth stand, enthralled in a tale, a book in his hand. Yet evocative as letters on parchment may be, 'tis words said and heard which impel destiny." All right, so those are the 3 clues. And then basically what happens is you can't open this box until you have those keys. You get given a letter, which you, of course, can read again. Right, so the first thing then, I mean, I already know the locations of these, so we're just going to go to them. The first place that we're going to go to is X7.9, so let's find that. Bob, 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 bob. All right, that axis, and then Y13.8. So that brings us down here. So just around here, we should find our first person. Now, as I stated previously, we're looking for somebody who may or may not be asleep, because obviously that's the implication of that first clue. Quite a simple one that could rack your brain. The key important part of the actual story then is that it did say that for you to basically embrace that as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to go over to these coordinates like so, and we should find somebody asleep in theory, if I've believe this correct. There we go, sleepy student. So he's over there, he's near the life-giving waters where the watcher, and he's sleeping. So all we do is do /doze to make our character doze around. Actually, I'm not sure if we have to target the student. I think we might have to do that. Let's try that. It should work. Please work. There we go. And the student awakes. And it's sleepy student question mark? I've been waiting for you, Mione. Here, my master bade you give you this key. To go so far as to disguise himself as a woman, it shows how much he wanted to meet you in person. Anyway, I've played my part, so I'll return to my training. Enjoy the rest of your game. So there's the first of the three keys, right here. So far, it makes perfect sense. So let's work on the second clue then. So let's just have a refresher. Open this up again. Doobie-doobie-doo. We've done that one. But the second one is, by life ever flowing, a keeper doth wait. Right, so life ever flowing, that's water, right? Clutching a prize, his hunger to sate. So he's clutching something that he eats, I guess. Yet no prize is so coveted as one golden-hued. So we're still talking about prize in the idea of food. So a golden food, The mention of which is never thought rude. So we've got to mention something. Okay, so the next location is actually, if I recall correctly, because I've already found bits and pieces about this on the internet, but it makes more sense now. If you're anything like me, you look this stuff up, because after a while of trying to find out, it, eats away at you. But yeah, so if you get stuck, so apparently it's over here. So let's go and have a look over there. So regarding those clues then, so something golden that's eaten. Now, I racked my brains over this part of the clue for the longest time before I just gave up and had to look up on basically things like Garland tools to figure out what was involved in the quest. And I don't think you would necessarily get this. It would take you a very long time of running around. So the golden thing is actually, well, you'll see. So if we go down here, you'll find none other, right in the corner here, Nutkin, little Nutkin. And if you talk to Nutkin, it says, could this Nutkin be one of the keepers? Perhaps you should review the letter. So you could stumble across this. You could stumble across this. The likelihood of me finding this, probably very little. I didn't even think about coming up here. It would take me a while to map this entire place. So basically, what you need to do is use say command to talk to Nutkin. And you mention a golden prize to him. What is he clutching? He's clutching an acorn. So we type in golden acorn. Because it's a golden one. And boom. It's not Nutkin. Well done, my friend. From the tales I heard about you, I expected you'd find me in short order. And you did. Heard from who, you ask? Oh, just a man I admire. It was due to his influence that I decided to train under the same master. What joy to see him again after all these years. My disguise I chose because I felt it to be a good match for him. Quite convincing, don't you think? Ah, but forget. But before I forget, here's your key. I'll let you get back to the game. But when you have a moment, I'd love to hear some of your tales. So there's that former Nutkin. So that's two of the keys. And then we're looking for one last person, right? Or thing, or whatever it could be. So there's the first two. The third one is blessed by the nymphi, a keeper doth stand, enthralled in a tale, a book in his hand. So that's already implicating somebody who's like scholarly, maybe with a book. Yet evocative as letters on parchment may be, 'tis words said and heard which impel destiny. So there is a particular character, and it could be literally anybody in this entire place. My guess would be the studium. I think most people would have guessed that. Right, well, Turns out it's not anywhere near the stadium, so I was completely off. 11.5 is our X coordinate, and our Y coordinate is 8.5, which is around here. Now, the clue is the Nymphaeum, right? But how many people even registered that in their brain? I didn't read that and go, oh, the Nymphaeum's the name of a place. I thought it was like the name of a statue or something. So it is possible to figure this out, but you would really have to look at the map and explore and take it all in, which is all, you know, the whole reason that you would spend hours on this. In many ways, I kind of regret looking up the answer, like you probably are right now. But some people are just going to be like, well, what exactly is this? So, there should be around here. Wait, is this exactly where it should be? Am I getting this right? No. There, Izumi. Here we go. So there's someone in an Nymphaeum with a book. So if you think of it that way, it was quite simple. But I could not figure this out for some reason. My brain didn't have enough coffee, clearly. And then you just talk to them. Greetings, Mione. That you sought me out means you've read the letter and solved the riddle besides. Of all our master's pupils, your comrade is the least poetic by far. But that's never stopped him from trying to woo the ladies with song. He truly is hopeless. Still, it's good to see him hale and whole. From what master tells us, he's been through a lot. The next time you see him, do pass along my regards. And here, of course, is your key. So who is the master? That's my question. Now, the only person I know that woos ladies is Thancred. Am I wrong? I don't know. But that's pretty much what you have to do for this quest. Now, the real question is, was it actually worth it at all? Well, we're going to get some experience from the quest. As far as I know, it's in the range of 168k to 190k. The keys unlock the box, which would open to reveal along with another letter. Dear Mione, allow me to congratulate you for solving the riddles. As promised, the gift is yours to take. A long time ago, Master Louisoir left a little troublemaker in my care. At his behest, I taught the boy everything I knew in the ways of survival and infiltration. After years away from these shores, the boy has returned a man. By the set of his face alone, 'tis plain he has matured greatly. A product of the time he has had with the Scions, no, I do not doubt. Thank you for being there for him, and ask that you continue to do so. Lastly, I ask that you forgive me for not saying this directly. In spite of myself, I've never been good at expressing heartfelt sentiments in person, hence this letter. The manner of its delivery, at the very least, I wish to make interesting, and I hope you derive some enjoyment from it. And the reward is a Chondrite ring coffer. This is a level 88 ring. And that was all that was in the box. So all of that curiosity. I mean, it is a cool looking ring. Let's not lie. The Chondrite stuff's pretty cool. But that, my friends, is literally what that riddle was for. So, yeah, I thought it would be something completely different, and probably many of you would have said the same thing. But I guess the real prize was the journey we had all along? I don't know. You let me know in the comments section what you think about this. And from a lore perspective, it's awesome. But, yeah, let me know what you think about this. And hopefully this was interesting, if not helpful. And I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye.